So the challenge of COVID-19, at least what we're hearing from other centers, is that these patients are profoundly hypoxic. And so the act of intubating them to put them on a ventilator actually does put the patient at some risk. The people who are doing the intubation therefore need to be very skilled, and they need to be part of a team that has rehearsed the protocols for managing these types of patients.
So it's working together with the team to come up with a particular sort of emergency tray and a whole airway preparation area in the merge so that we can respond quickly as these patients come in critical condition. And practicing over at the simulation center with both the nurses and the residents and the physicians.
About a month ago, we gathered at the simulation center with our colleagues from nursing and respiratory therapy and from critical care medicine, and we established number of protocols for managing people with COVID-19. Those protocols were developed here, they were rehearsed here, and then once we were happy with them, we've taken them over to the hospital where they're being practiced on a daily basis by interprofessional teams, which include nursing, respiratory therapy, as well as people from emergency medicine. As difficult as it's been to anticipate and prepare for the COVID-19 crisis, it's also given us a chance to reflect on how well we can gather as interprofessional teams to prepare for a crisis like this, and how a center like the Clinical Simulation Center can support that, both with their staff and their equipment.